In this video, I'm going to show you how we can post general journal entries with automatic reversals in SAP S for HANA using Fiori. I'm here on the Fiori launchpad and we will navigate to the application called Post General Journal Entries. Select this application and over here you can see the start screen to post our general journal entry. Now before we select any field over here and fill it with data, we will do the following. We will click here on Select Templates and then we will scroll down a bit. Up until we can see the template called standard_5 template for auto reversal. This template is used to post our general journal entry with an auto reversal. So we select this one. Now you can see that the screen changed a bit. So despite our header attachments, notes and balance section, we also have here now a separate tab called auto reversal. Now before we click on this auto reverse tab over here, let's fill the header information. So we will provide our journal entry date and we check also if the posting date and the journal entry type is filled over here. Then as always, you need to provide a company code and a transaction currency. That's basically it. Now we will go to the auto reverse section over here. We must insert a reversal reason. So as you can see, there are different reasons defined. You can even define your own ones in the customizing. But for now, we will say here auto reverse. Then we must provide a planned reversal date, so the date on which our journal entry will then be reversed by the system. Let's say the 11th of May, like that. Now it's time here to fill the line items. So we will click over here and then we will just provide a bank account like that with a debit of let's say 100. And then we will provide a petty cash account in our example like that with a credit of 100. You can see here the system now displays a green balance. Also, we could provide, of course, more line items or even expand here the sections to include more information for the different line items. But for now, this is fine. Please be aware that, as you can see over here, there's a warning message, as we can see that the reversal date and the posting date are in the same period. So normally, the reversal would be done, for instance, for accruals and so on. So normally, it would be the next posting period. But for now, this is fine because I want to show you how we can actually post this automatic reversal there. So this is fine. We can even scroll down a bit. And then we can see here text information if necessary, but for now there is no text included. So that's basically it. Now we can simulate via this button over here. So as you can see, we are forwarded here to the Manage Journal Entries application where we can see the posting. So far this looks good. So we can click on post. And as you can see, one journal entry was posted and is also directly displayed over here. As you can see, the planned reversal date was inserted. So with that, we are not actually done because the system won't automatically reverse this journal entry as of now. What we need to do is the following. We will go to the application called Schedule General Ledger Jobs. Click on this one. And with this application, we can actually define and execute several different jobs for our financial transactions. So we will click on Create. And then you can see here, we need to select a template first. So as you can see, the system already chose a template for foreign currency valuation, but this is not correct. So we will hit here on the X and then on this symbol over here. Now we can select different templates. As you can see, there are many templates. However, we will now use the template called Post General Journal Entries with Auto Reversal. Select this one. You can see the job template name was copied to the job name. However, we can always adjust the job name if necessary. I would always advise you to give it a meaningful name so that you can easily identify the job later on. So let's just say Auto Reversal and then a company code and then also the month we are in. Something like that. Now let's click on step two. Over here we can say that either we want the job to start immediately by this indicator, or we can deselect it like that and then provide a start time and time zone. So when the job should actually be executed. Also you can see over here the recurrence pattern is actually a single run over here right now. So this means that this job will be executed only once. However, if you want the system to execute such jobs on a regular basis, I would advise you to click on this button here called Define Recurrence Pattern. With this button, you can say that, for instance, you want the auto postings to be executed on a minute basis, hourly basis, daily, weekly, or monthly basis. So if we are talking, for instance, about accruals, it would make sense to have here a monthly recurrence pattern. And then you could say here every, let's say, 1 month. And also you can say that you want this at the beginning of the month, end of the month, or a certain weekday. Then you can choose here also the days. So right now, this job would be executed monthly on the first of every month. And you can also say it should end never or by a certain time or after a certain number of occurrences. You can even restrict for non-working days and also select a calendar that should be considered when the system now creates this automatic job. Via this button, you could also reset your scheduling options if necessary. For now, we will leave it as is and say start immediately. Now next off, we go to step 3. And over here we could restrict our job for certain company codes, even document numbers or fiscal years. Let's say at least 2025 over here. And we can even restrict for a planned reversal date. So I will say the 11th of May to just select the document I just posted. We could also say recalculate local currency amounts. And when we hit this indicator, then we say that we want the amount in the reversal journal entry to be recalculated using the exchange rate of the planned reversal date. For now, we will leave it as is. Then I would advise you to select the test run first. We can always check here. And we could even now save this template here to reuse it later on. Let me quickly show this to you. If you click over here and say save as and just give it a name like that, then we can always reuse the template in the template selection over here. You can see if I deselect this and scroll down, also our saved template is displayed. Okay, so far so good. For now, I will execute it actually in a productive run. However, as said, I would always recommend you to choose test run first. Okay, we will click on schedule. And you can see we are automatically forwarded to the initial screen of this application and the status of our job is now in process. You can always click on go. As you can see, now it's finished. There's actually a warning message. We can click on this one. There you will see that certain warnings are being displayed, but this is fine. And if we go to the results section, we can also see that the document we created was reversed successfully. So what we can actually do right now is we can navigate to the application called Manage Journal Entries New Version over here. Then we will select our company code, the journal entry date, so the 11th of May. Hit on go. And over here we can see the initial document we posted. If we select this one, we can also see over here it was reversed by another document. And this is because we executed the automatic job I've shown you before. We can click on this one and click on Manage Journal Entries. And then we are forwarded to the reversal document. Okay, this marks the end of the video. I hope you liked it. If so, then please subscribe to the channel and activate the bell. See you next time.